autistic cooperative. And I want to address some things here today. What you all might not know is that autistic people, the number one cause of early death for us is suicide. Our median age is 36 years. This isn't because how we're born with autistic brains. This is because of the environment that is so hostile, the difference that we face every single day. We have children ages 6 years old trying to complete suicide. We have them at all ages. This doesn't matter where you live. It doesn't matter where culture you come from. It doesn't matter what country you come from. This is a crisis. On the very, very lowest level of completion, we have males at 9 times higher risk for suicide because of this, and women are 14. I have heard numbers up to 24%, and that's far more believable knowing the autistic community as I do, because none of you have any idea what that is, because unfortunately our help never came. Our help came in other ways. Our help came with conversion therapy, which makes the adults who survived ABA, 48 to 72% of them now have PTSD with even as 1 year. Okay, so we have these facilities. We have nowhere for our kids to go. Our adult autistic people need homes like this. We need better treatment than what we've been getting. And with number one cause of being death is suicide for our early death, if I go here, because I do struggle with my own mental illness and I do live with severe PTSD so bad, I have functional neurological disorder. I have PTSD so bad from sexual trauma, from growing up from 6 different people until I was ages 4 to 16, I sit in this chair. Mental illness is so stigmatized. No one here that I've heard speaking understands it at all. And it's killing my people. And this town in Clovis and this community has a very large autistic population. And you know, 10% of homeless people were autistic. We are here and we need this kind of help, and there's nothing. If I go now to a 5150 crisis, I will be turned away because I am autistic. They have no protocols for me. I can't go to Stanford and stay at their help for my functional neurological disorder because I'm autistic. They don't know how to help me. This is a super huge problem, and it's not just defined to people that they define. Okay? We need help, and we need help like this, and we need help from people like this. This is a far bigger thing coming. And so for every one of you who ever lit up blue, how about you try and light up gold and help us live and be human and stop treating this way? Because how it affects my community is how it affects my community of peers who live with mental illness too, only they don't have the combined voice that we do right now. We are worthy of life, and we are worthy of living in homes, and we're worthy of neighborhoods and families and gardens and backyards. Hate speech is all I can do. Thank you.